Hi, good morning to all. Welcome to Phoenix Coaching Center. Myself, A. Kumaresan, chemistry faculty in Phoenix Coaching Center. I completed my undergraduation and post-graduation as a gold medalist in Vivekananda College, Chennai. Right now, I'm pursuing my PhD in chemistry from University of Madras. Let's see more about our institution. Phoenix is a dedicated coaching institute for farms graduates, especially those who are preparing for agricultural services and other horticultural services and other TNPSC related government examinations. We are offering good study materials based on TNPSC revised syllabus. We have 10 printed books also available, 19 previous years old question papers compiled in there. Our Phoenix Institution established in the year 2016, compiled by various scientists, professors, and research scholars. I think in general studies, we have general science topic is there. In general science, physics, chemistry, and biology, I am focusing on chemistry only. Let's see more about our chemistry topic. Let me share my screen. We have short demo class on chemistry chapters. So first one, acids, bases, and salts. We are well known for acids. I think we all remember in chemistry, all the chemical in school life, chemical laboratories, acids are used like hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid or nitric acid. So these are the chemicals common in our chemistry lab. So bases and salt, we'll see later. First one, acids. So acid can be derived from the Latin name, and that is acides. So acid having some physical properties, that is sour taste, it having sour taste. So for example, HCl is a hydrochloric acid, contains one replaceable hydrogen atoms. That is, acid contains one or more replaceable hydrogen atom. If you take HCl, put into water, so what will happen? So it will ionize, that is H plus and Cl minus split into ions. So in that, H plus is a acid, because it will donate proton or it will accept electron based on various acid base theories. Okay. So next one, acids conduct electricity in aqueous solutions. Then acid turns blue litmus to red color. So while putting in any indicator, it can changes its color. Next one, sources of acids. I think acid, and we converted classified into two types, that is inorganic acids and organic acids. So these are all organic acids. Actually, apple is a source of malic acid. So then we are well known, lemon, orange, these are all citric acids. Grape contains tartaric acid. Tomato contains oxalic acid, then vinegar present acetic acid, lactic acid present in curd, and tea in tannic acid, and for our digestion process, hydrochloric acid is very much, and in ant and bee, formic acid is present. So let's see about various acids and ions formed in water. So actually, acetic acid is a formula for CH3COOH. So it will put into water, it will form ions. So that is H plus and CH3COO minus. So here it contains how many number of replaceable hydrogen atom for acetic acid, formic acid, and nitric acid is only one. But in case of sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4. So it contains two replaceable hydrogen atom. It can split into ions like 2H plus and SO4 2 minus. So number of replaceable hydrogen atom is 2. In case of phosphoric acid is a formula, H3PO4. Actually, it contains 3H+ ions in aqueous state. That is, it will ionize form 3H+ and PO4 3-. So here, total number of replaceable hydrogen atom for phosphoric acid is 3. So these questions will very important for TNPSC general science chemistry, especially for chemistry. Next one. So types of acids. As I told earlier, so acids can be classified into two types mainly. That is organic acids and inorganic acids. So organic acids, that is derived from plant and animals. For example, acetic acid, that is HCOOH. HCOOH is a formic acid present in ant or bee. Then acetic acid, CH3COOH, it is present in vinegar. Next one, inorganic acids. So inorganic acids are in common labs available, that is prepared from rocks and minerals. For example, hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, and sulfuric acid, these are all example for inorganic acids. Then based on ionization, the acid can be classified into three more types, that is monobasic acid and the dibasic acid and the tribasic acid. Okay, so first, what is meant by monobasic acid? In monobasic acid, it will give only one hydrogen atom per molecule in solution. For example, HCl and HNO3. Already I told HCl ionize into H+ and Cl-. So there is only one hydrogen atom per molecule. For HNO3, in this case also only one replaceable hydrogen atom. Then dibasic acid. So dibasic acid means it will give two hydrogen atom or ions per molecule in solution. That is H2SO4, that is sulfuric acid. So it's split into ions. So 2H+ and SO4 2-. Then for H2CO3 means carbonic acid. Carbonic acid, it have two hydrogens. So it will form dibasic acid. Then tribasic acid. So tribasic acid, for example, H3PO4 is a phosphoric acid. So it contains three hydrogens. So that means tribasic acid gives three hydrogen ions per molecule in solution. So next one, strong acids and weak acids. So actually strong acid, these are identified by depending on the strength. So first is strong acid, for example, HCl. HCl ionizes completely in water. If the acid ionizes completely in water, that is strong acid. If the acid ionizes only partially ionizes in water, that is weak acids. For example, weak acid, acetic acid, CH3COOH is a weak acetic acid. Then concentrated acid and diluted acid. So concentrated acid means it has contained large amount of acid dissolved in a solvent. For example, if you take 10 ml water, then plus 90 ml concentrated acid. So that is 90 ml is the ratio. So 90 ml means it is very concentrated. But if you take 90 ml water, 90 ml water, just 10 ml add water, just 10 ml add acid. So that is diluted condition. So actually concentrated acid is large amount of acid dissolved in a solvent. For diluted acid, very smaller amount of acid dissolved in a solvent. Then move on, strength of acids. I think strength of acids is in a lot of questions in TNPSC. So it depends on the properties of acids. So actually from top, bottom to top, from here, hydrogen and the OH-, these are very ammonia. So these are very weak acids. Then acetic acid and hydrofluoric acid, HF means hydrofluoric acid. HNO2 is a nitrous acid and H3O+ is hydronium ion. So these are all moderate or weak acids. Compared to very weak acids, these are all moderate. Then strong acids. So strong acids are HNO3 and H2SO4, HCl and HClO4. HClO4 is a hydrochlorous acid. So these are all strong acids. So for I think one question has in TNPSC. So which one is the strongest acid? So here from top to bottom to top. So hydrogen to HCl4. So HCl4 is the top of the table. So HCl4 is the strongest acid. Very weak acid is H2. So in right hand side, this is conjugate bases. So for actually acid, for bronzed acid, H plus donor. For bronzed base, H plus acceptor. So we'll see this one in later. Then uses of acids. Actually, sulfuric acid is H2SO4 is a sulfuric acid. It is commonly known as king of chemicals because majority of uses using sulfuric acid only. So it is used in automobile industry, that is car batteries, lorry batteries, or bus batteries. So that is the use. Then hydrochloric acid, HCl is used as a cleansing agent in toilet for all the toilet cleaner apparatus things. So HCl is present in it. So next one, nitric acid, HNO3 is nitric acid. It can be used in the manufacture of fertilizers, dyes, paints, and drugs. Then citric acid used as a food preservative. Then oxalic acid, it can bleach for wood and removing black stains in that. Then carbonic acid. So for carbonic acid used in aerated drinks. So the aerated drinks means that 7-Up bottles, Pepsi, Coke, and all the cool drinks items contain carbonic acid. So that's why if you shake it and open it, it will effervescence will come. So because of aerated, because carbon dioxide CO2 is present in that. Okay. So next one, tartaric acid. Tartaric acid is used in the baking, used as a baking powder. Then next, we move on bases. So actually, acid releases H plus ions, but in bases, base releases OH minus ions in water. Actually, its property is bitter in taste and soapy to touch. For example, washing soda, Na2CO3, and the caustic soda, NaOH, caustic potash, KOH. These are all the examples. So if you see here, NaOH is put into water, so it will form ions, Na plus and the OH minus ion. Okay, so here OH minus is a hydroxide ion, so it is a base. So bases changes red litmus to blue color. It will see in later. So next one for indicator. So bases add with phenolphthalein indicator, it will form pink color. While with the methyl orange indicator, it will form, bases will form yellow color. Like acids, bases also conduct electricity in aqueous solutions. Next one, various bases and ions formed in water. For like acids, bases also form ions in water. So first one, potassium hydroxide, formula KOH, ions in ionic state, K plus and OH minus ion. So here the number of replaceable hydroxyl ion is only one. And next one, calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide formula is CaOH2. So here it will form ions. So Ca2 plus and OH minus ion. Okay. So in that, here because two hydroxyl ions are there. So number of replaceable hydroxyl ion is two. Then aluminum hydroxide. Aluminum hydroxide, AlOH3, is a molecular formula. So it will ionize in water. From Al3 plus and OH minus ion, 3 OH minus ion. So here the number of replaceable hydroxyl ion is 3. This is very important for exams. Next one, monoacidic, diacidic, triacidic base. So based on the ionization, it will be classified. So first one, monoacidic base. For monoacidic base, ionizes in water to give 1 hydroxyl ion per molecule. So as I told earlier in the table, NaOH, KOH having only one hydroxyl ion. The next one, diacidic base. It ionizes in water to give 2 hydroxyl ion per molecule. That is calcium hydroxide contain 2 hydroxyl ion and magnesium hydroxide contain 2 hydroxyl ions. The next one, triacidic base. So triacidic base ionizes in water to give 3 hydroxyl ions per molecule. So here aluminum hydroxide is an example. So AlOH stress contains three hydroxide ions and FeOH stress, that is ferric hydroxide. So in this three hydroxide ions also available. So next one, all the alkalis are bases, but not all bases are alkalis. That is alkali, I think in periodic table, left side of the periodic table, that is S block elements. So S block elements are first group contain two group elements, first group and second group. That is first group elements contain alkali metals, second group elements contains alkaline earth metals. So that metals only called as alkalis. Okay. So here, if you see here, NaOH and KOH. So here the Na and K are alkali metals. So these are alkalis. But if you see here, aluminum hydroxide and zinc hydroxide, these are all not from alkali metals. So these are bases. So this is the difference. So all the alkalis are bases, but not all the bases are alkalis. So next one, depending upon the amount of water added in base, so it will be concentrated and diluted. So relatively for concentrated alkali, relatively high percentage of alkali in its solution. Diluted alkali, relatively low percentage of alkali in its aqueous solution. Okay. So next one, strong bases. Strong bases and weak bases. Strong bases like NaOH and KOH, these are ions completely in aqueous solution. So that is called strong bases. But bases with ions partially in aqueous solution, that is called weak bases. For example, ammonium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, these are all partially only ionized in aqueous solution. So next one, uses of bases. So base, first one, sodium hydroxide. So sodium hydroxide is especially used in the manufacture of soap. I think in all the soaps are soap manufacturing process, sodium hydroxide plays a major role in that. So that the manufacturing of soap is called, that reaction is called a saponification reaction, see later. Next one, calcium hydroxide. So calcium hydroxide we use for whitewashing of building. Then next one, magnesium hydroxide. So magnesium hydroxide is a medicinal purpose for stomach disorders. Then next one, ammonium hydroxide. It can remove grease stains from cloths. So in while playing somewhere, so the cloths having grease stains, for using ammonium hydroxide, it will remove easily. So next one, test for acids and bases. So acid base indicator. So indicator used. So first one, litmus indicator. So while litmus indicator in acid, so color will be changed from blue to red, but litmus paper add in bases, so color will change from red to blue, as I told earlier in that. So next one, phenolphthalein. So acid in phenolphthalein indicator, it will form colorless, but in base it will form pink color solution. And then methyl orange. So while using methyl orange indicator used in acid, it will form pink color, but in base it will form yellow color solution. So this is the image for a test, acid base test. So if you see here, so this is a blue litmus paper. If you put into water, it will form red litmus. So that is a litmus. Okay, so blue to red. So next one, phenolphthalein indicator. While using for phenolphthalein indicator in acid, it will form colorless. In base, it will form pink color. Next one, methyl orange. In methyl orange, it will form as in acid, it will form light pink color, and in base, it will form yellow color, as I told earlier. Next one, acid base theories. So there are three major types theories present in that. So first one, Arrhenius theory. Second one, Bronsted-Lowry theory, and Lewis concept. Okay. So in Arrhenius theory, acid dissociate to give H plus ions. That is, if you take HCl, that is acid. If you put into water, it will form H plus and Cl minus ions. So that is Arrhenius theory. Then for base. So dissociates to give OH minus ions. For example, NaOH and calcium hydroxide. Next, move on Bronsted-Lowry theory. So in Bronsted-Lowry theory, acid. So Bronsted acid is a proton donor. Okay. For example, if you see here, so HCl is an acid and H2 is a base. Because acid in Bronsted-Lowry theory, Bronsted acid becomes proton donor and Bronsted base becomes proton acceptor. In this example clearly explained, because HCl here, it will, that HCl contains H plus ion. So it will donate proton to water. So it will form H2O plus. But in H2O, it will accept proton to form H2O plus. Okay. So next one, Lewis concept. So in Lewis concept, Lewis acid accept as an electron pair, but base donates an electron pair. So if you see here, acid, BF3, Al3. So these are all Lewis acid example, but for Lewis base, ammonia and water. So how can we identify? We'll see later. So Lewis acids and bases. So difference between Lewis acids and bases. For Lewis acid, it is electron deficient molecules. So because there is no electrons available. So that is BF3 and AlCl3 and BF2. These are all electron deficient molecules. Okay. But for Lewis bases, it will contains lone pair of electrons available in that. For example, in ammonia, in here, there is one lone pair is there. For water, here oxygen, one lone pair is there. Here ROH. So in oxygen atom contains lone pair. In RNH2, nitrogen contains lone pair. So Lewis bases contains electron rich species. Lewis acid contains electron deficient species. Okay. So next one, all the metal ions are atoms. So here Lewis acids. So acid means it is deficient. Base means it has anions. So here negative charge. All the negative charge ions are Lewis bases. All the positive ions, that is cations, so have Lewis bases. Then molecule contains a polar double bond. Okay. So here SO2, CO2 and SO3, not SO2, SO3. So these are all double bonds. So Lewis bases, molecules contain carbon-carbon multiple bond. So for example, CH2 double bond, CH2, this is Lewis acid, sorry, Lewis base. Then triple bond, acetylene. This is ethylene and acetylene. So let's see one question from Lewis acid and base. So question is, while chromium complex reacted with water to form chromium complex. You see here in the hydration of ion. So question, what is the question means? So which one act as a Lewis base, which one act as a Lewis acid? So as I told earlier, all the metal ions are Lewis acids because they are electron deficient species. For in chromium 3 plus ion, that is deficient of 3 plus charge. But in water, it will become electron rich species because in water, oxygen contains lone pair is there. Okay. So this is the question. So here the Lewis acid is chromium ion and the Lewis base is water. Very, very important for examination point of view. Next one, salt. Next one, salt. Actually, acid and base will form salt. So that is, acid and base react with each other to form a neutral product is called salt. That is, for example, NaCl. Okay. So actually, salt properties are hygroscopic in nature. So hygroscopic na enna paathina onnum illa ipo namba vandu ipo mala naal la vandu just the salt bottle vandu nam open panni vittona enna or liquid mer convert aayidum. So adhu dhaan vandu hygroscopic nature nu solluvanga. So idha vandu ipo onnum illa simple la paathina ipo NaCl. So NaCl vandu water la ionize panna idha enna aagum. So vandu Na plus Cl minus ions split aayidum. So இப்போ இதுக்கு முன்னாடி வந்து acid base ரெண்டுமே வந்து எலக்ட்ரிசிட்டி கண்டக்ட் பண்ணணும்னு பார்த்தோம். பட் ஆனா இந்த கேஸ்ல salt வந்து salt formula molten state, அதாவது salt formula வந்து கண்டக்ட் பண்ணாது. ஆனா வாட்டர்ல போட்டு அயனைஸ் ஆகும் போது ஈஸியா கண்டக்ட் பண்ணும். கண்டக்ட் எலக்ட்ரிசிட்டி. So So next one, if we are going to talk about single salt. So single salt example on the NaCl. This is double salt, combination of two simple salt. Combination of two simple salt in equal molar ratio, that is called double salt. Example, potash alum. So potash alum contains potassium sulfate, aluminum sulfate. There is two metals is there. Okay. Then next one, common salt. So common salt, say NaCl. So can be used as a preservative and daily food. And washing soda used for softening of hot water. And baking soda used in the baking industry. So it contains a mixture of soda and tartaric acid. And also used in soda acid fire extinguishers. So this one very well known, bleaching powder. So bleaching powder formula is calcium oxychloride, CaOCl2. It is very, very important in examination point of view. Used as a disinfectant and also used in textile industry for bleaching of cotton and linen. Next one, plaster of Paris. So its formula is CaSO4.H2O. So calcium sulfate hemihydrate is the name. So it can be used for plastering bones and for making cast. என்னன்னு பாத்தீங்கன்னா அந்த சிலையெல்லாம் வந்து அதுல ஒரு சில பார்ட்ஸை ஒட்ட வைக்கிறதுக்காக அதை வந்து யூஸ் பண்ணுவாங்க பிளாஸ்டர் பேரிஸ் நெக்ஸ்ட் வந்து அக்வரேஜியா சோ அக்வரேஜியா வந்து எதுக்காக யூஸ் பண்ணுவாங்க பாத்தீங்கன்னா அந்த கோல்ட் எல்லாம் வந்து ரிஃபைன் பண்றதுக்காக யூஸ் பண்ணுவாங்க ஓகேங்களா சோ அது ஃபர்ஸ்ட் என்ன அப்படின்னு பாத்தீங்கன்னா கிங்ஸ் வாட்டர்னு சொல்லுவாங்க லாட்டின் ஃபிரேஸ் வந்து அக்வரேஜியன் பாத்தீங் ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் சும்மா அர்த்தம். நெக்ஸ்ட் இது வந்து என்ன இதுக்கு யூஸ் பண்றாங்க பாத்தீங்கன்னா, ஸோ ரிஃபைனிங் அண்ட் கிளீனிங் ஆஃப் கோல்டு. இது வந்து ஹைலி கரோசிவ் லிக்யூட். ஸோ என்ன பண்ணும், கோல்டை வந்து ஈஸியாக வந்து கொரோட் பண்றோம், ஓகேங்களா. ஸோ நெக்ஸ்ட் வந்து பிஹெச் ஸ்கேல். ஸோ பிஹெச் ஸ்கேல் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா இன்ட்ரோடியூஸ்ட் பை எஸ்பிஎல் சரன்சன். ஸோ இதில் வந்து பிஇன்றது என்னன்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா பொட்டன்ஷியல்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. ஜெர்மனில் என்ன மீனிங்னா பவர், பொட்டன்ஷியல் பவர்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. ஸோ பிஹெச் வேல்யூஸ் வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா எதுக்காக யூஸ் பண்ணுறாங்கன்னா, ஸோ இதை வச்சு டிசைட் பண்ணலாம் வெதர் சொல்யூஷன் கேன் பி அசிடிக் ஆர் பேசிக் ஆர் நியூட்ரல். ஸோ இப்போ கீழே கொடுத்துட்டு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா 0 to 14. ஸோ பிஹெச் ஸ்கேல் வந்து இதுதான் சொல்லுவாங்க. ஸோ அதில் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா நியூட்ரல் சொல்யூஷன் வந்து பிஹெச் வந்து 7 இருந்ததுன்னா அது நியூட்ரல் சொல்யூஷன் சொல்லுவாங்க. அசிடிக்ன்றது பிஹெச் லெஸ் தென் 7 கீழே இருந்ததுன்னா அசிடிக் சொல்யூஷன் சொல்லுவாங்க. For basic solution, pH greater than 7. So, in the demo class, we will conclude. So, we shall see remaining topics in live classes. So, thank you.